work.
Down in the town.
But
go on. See what's doing down in the
lower rent district.
But I prefers to stay.
Ah, does the preferring around here? And when I prefers, you concurs.
What now, Pansy?
Get. Ah, has spoken. Now you be sweet to that gal.
But Mammy, the boys is waiting for me.
Hish.
Morning, Mammy. Abner.
Morning, child.
Howdy, Daisy.
I bring you some worms, Abner.
Worms? A person would think it was Valentine's Day.
Thanks, Daisy.
Hope you like them. They's fresh, firm, and wriggly.
Just like your adorable self.
Oh, Mammy.
Well, thanks, Daisy. Oh, I better use these worms now. The boys is waiting for me.
Boys can wait. Ain't you and Daisy got some talking to do?
Is it about Sadie Hawkins Day?
Naturally.
I'm sorry, Daisy. That's one subject I just can't discuss. Well, seven for one thing. Why you keeps waiting around for me every year? You's liable to throw your whole life away. And I just couldn't stand that. Well, so this year, you's just gonna have to find yourself somebody else.
Sometimes I think I just hate Salabner.
Nah, you don't, child. And this year, you's gonna catch little Abner come Sadie Hawkins Day, even if you has to do business with the detestable, but ever available Jones.
Mammy.
Well, that sounds pretty good for the average man, Sam, but tell me, since I am prepared to extend myself financially, what have you got in a $2 wedding?
Ooh, my $2 wedding. My boy, it is spectacular. First, I strips to the waist and wrestles the four biggest guests, male or female. Morning, ladies.
Morning, Mary and Sam.
Come on, Sam. Tell us more.
Next, I tell four off-color jokes, guaranteed to embarrass man or beast.
Then, as the applause dies down, I dance as a jig with a pig, ties my arms and legs to four infuriated mules, and as they start to run off in all four directions trying to tear me apart, I recite five of the more dynamic speeches of Dan Quayle backwards.
Well, that sounds pretty good for the lower classes, but the lady I has in mind is entitled to something a little more than hoi polloi. Morning, ladies. My Daisy May, you are looking especially pretty today.
Thank you, Mr. McGill.
And just what does a rat varmint like you want with information about a $2 wedding?
Could be I'm fixing to get married. Since I have returned home with my newly acquired title, namely World's Dirtiest Wrestler. And being so well-heeled, well, naturally I aims to wed me a certain dog patch gal.
You crazy or something?
You know a man can't claim a gal less than she catches him herself on Sadie Hawkins Day.
If you want the answer, sweetie, I suggest you preambulate over to the fog-bound meeting. Just about to be held over at Cornpone Square.
Cornpone Square? You mean this is going to be a cornpone meeting?
By direct request to my very good friend, Senator Jackass Fogbound.
This could be serious.
We only have cornpone meetings of events of national importance.
Or a hideous change in the dog patch way alive.
There's gonna be a hideous change, all right. Come on, Sam. I want you to tell me about your $4 wedding.
Well, I don't crave your business, but I can't discriminate either. Well, first I clips your toenails and gives you a quick shave and a sponge bath if you need it. And, woo, frankly, I say you need it. Next, I make a shot.
Looks bad, Daisy. You hightail it up to Polecat Creek and tell Abner and those no-good skunks to get over to that meeting.
Right. But what if they druther not?
You tell them I druther, they druther. And when Panther Yoakum says she druther, they druther.
Druther, they druther.
I ain't in a fly-flicking mood.
Why, you sound like something bothered
you. Well, I bet you I know. Sadie Hawkins Day's coming up.
Abner, you figuring on letting Daisy May catch you this year?
Oh, I don't think so. It ain't worth the price.
Price? What price?
Why, giving up your druthers.
Which druthers?
Why, all of them. Why, you'd rather go hunting, she'd rather stay home. You'd rather do this, she'd rather do that. Why, boys, I tell you, the day you kiss your bride hello, you kiss your druthers goodbye.
Well, I didn't know your druthers was that important to you.
Important? If I had my druthers, I'd rather have my druthers than anything else I know. While you'd rather hustle, accumulate muscle, I'd rather watch daisies grow. While they're growing slow and the summer breeze is blowing, my heart is overflowing, and so if I had my druthers, I'd rather have my druthers than anything else I know, than anything else I know. If I had my druthers, I'd rather have my druthers than do any work at all. It ain't that I hates it, I often contemplates it while watching the raindrops fall. I sit there for hours, developing my powers, a figuring how flowers gets tall. If I had my druthers, I'd rather have my druthers than do any work at all.
Hey, Hammer! If you could be anyone in the whole world, who would you rather be?
Me?
Just you?
Just me.
What's so important about being you?
Well, ain't nothing special about it. It's just so handy, that's all. If I had my druthers to choose from all the others, I'd rather be like I am. This thing called employment detracts from my enjoyment and tightens my diaphragm. While I'm doing nary a thing that's necessary, I'm happy as a cherry stone clam. If I had my druthers to choose from all the others, I'd rather be like I am, yes ma'am. I'd rather be like I am.
Abner, Mammy says for you ought to come on down to the meeting.
I ain't a going to no meeting.
Thought I might walk along with you to the meeting.
But I'd rather stay here.
Thought we might do some talking about some things that might need some talking about.
Well, maybe we ought to do some talking. I ain't a-going. Daisy, you run along.
But Abner, Sadie Hawkins Day's next Friday, and if we's ever gonna do some talking...
I told you, Daisy, I ain't a-going.
But Abner...
I ain't a-going. I have spoken.
All right. Tell Mammy you ain't a coming to the corn pone meeting.
Corn pone meeting?
Of course.
But you didn't say it was a corn pone meeting.
You didn't let me.
Well, did you hear that, boys? A corn pone meeting. Well, this must be a national emergency. Well, we better get down there quick. This might call for some brains or something. What, Daisy, fetch me my worms.
Oh. If I had my druthers, I'd rather have some brothers to bash in his pumpkin head. It ain't that I hates him, I plumb adorates him and wishes that we was wed. I turns on my smolder in hopes that he'll get bolder, but I keeps getting older instead. If I had my druthers to choose from all the others, I'd rather that he'd drop.
Let's keep going.
Fellow citizens, as mayor of this upstanding community of Dogpatch, I, my honor, Daniel D. Dogmeat, declares open this solemn jubilation to Corn Pone meeting. This here meeting was requested by our esteemed senator, the Honorable Jack S. Fogbound.
Now wait a minute, Ruth. Don't womp that child. Scarlet, honey, come here. Honey, it's high time you learned that this town was founded by that beloved man sitting there up on that horse. Jubilation T. Cornpone. The greatest fighting general and military strategist the Confederacy ever knew.
Was he brave?
Brave? Why, J.T. Cornpone didn't know the meaning of the word fear. Terror, yes, but fear, never. And there's monuments all over the countryside commemorating the names of his famous battles.
Such as?
Cornpone's disaster. Cornpone's misjudgment. Cornpone's catastrophe. And Cornpone's humiliation. When we fought the Yankees and the annihilation was near, who was there to lead the charge that took us safe to the rear? Why, it was Jubilation T. Cornpone. Oh, toot your own horn, Pone. Jubilation T. Cornpone, a man who knew no fear.
Tell us more, Sam.
When we almost had him, but the issue still was in doubt.
Yeah.
Who suggested the retreat that turned it into a rout? Why, it was
Jubilation T. Cornpone.
Correct. All tattered and torn, Pone.
Jubilation T. Cornpone, he kept us hiding out.
With our ammunition gone and faced with utter defeat. Who was it that burned the crops and left us nothing to eat?
Why, it was Jubilation T. Cornpone.
Old September morn, Pone.
Jubilation T. Cornpone.
The pants blown off his seat.
Hooray!
History says that General Grant was pretty good with a jug. Who drank drink for drink with him and wound up under the rug.
Why, it was Jubilation T. Cornpone.
Passed out until morn, Pone.
Jubilation T. Cornpone.
The whiskers in his mug. Hearing that a northern spy had come to town for the night. Who gained entrance to her room and lost a glorious fight.
Why, it was Jubilation T. Cornpone.
Appomattox, Lee and Grant were present, of course. As Lee swept a tear away, who swept the back of his horse?
Why, it was Jubilation T. Cornpone. Foot sword for Lord Pone. Jubilation T. Cornpone, a picture of remorse. Why, it was Jubilation T. Cornpone.
Completely outworn Pone. Jubilation T. Cornpone, he really
mighty fine singing, Sam, but we've got to get on with this meeting. Now, the first thing on our agenda...
I want to know how come we've been having a cornpone meeting.
Admiral, my boy, the answer to that's a coming up the road. Fellow citizens, our esteemed senator, the Honorable Jack S. Fogbound.
Mayor Dogmeat, my beloved constituents of Dogpatch, I could stand here and bask in the sunshine of your warm greeting forever.
Bask on your own dime, Fogbound.
Yeah, get to the point.
Now, I bet you all wonder what I've been doing in Washington these last 18 years.
Well, we didn't care, just as long as you was there and we was here.
Go on, Senator. Tell everybody what you've been doing for us up yonder in Washington.
I has done got the United States Senate to pass the Jack S. Fogbound bill.
There's no Jack S. I got Jack S.
Through my efforts, little old Dogpatch, obscure, unknown, poverty-stricken Dogpatch, is going to be world famous.
And just what cause we going to be famous for? Quick for
save the lifeblood of a vigorous, thriving American industry. That's what for.
Why, which industry is that, Senator?
My boy, a glorious young industry devoted solely to the stimulation and relaxation so necessary to the American businessman. An industry known as Las Vegas.
Las Vegas?
Ain't that where they do all that gambling?
Yes, sir, Mammy Yoakum, and right there's their problem. You see, in the desert nearby, the government is a-shooting off certain nuclear weapons of war.
Atom bombs!
That's right. And the atomic dust of them bombs is a-floating down and a-settling in the Las Vegas swimming pools and on them beautiful green felt crapshooting tables.
Oh, that whole industry.
I tell you, the dice is turning black, hiding a spot so you can't hardly tell whether you've got snake eyes or boxcars. Oh. And that green felt is turning so brown you can't hardly tell whether your money's playing the field or coming the hard way. Oh. The colors is going off of them slot machines.
No!
Oh, yes, they is. You can't tell no more whether you got two cherries or three plums, three bells or two oranges. No! And if you hit the jackpot, you don't dare touch your money because it might be radioactive.
Oh, that whole industry.
Now, does you think that your government up there in Washington is gonna stand by and let a tragedy like this happen to an American industry to whom so many have given so much for so little?
No!
No, my good friends. And that's why the Jack S. Fogbrown Committee has been chosen.
To find a new place to test the bombs.
That's right. Some place that we can blow off the face of the earth. Some place that ain't ever gonna be missed. In fact, the most unnecessary place in the whole USA.
Well, well, I'll be dogged.
And I now has the honor and privilege of announcing that after a 4-year governmental survey of all the no good, no account, unnecessary places in this whole country, you has been selected as the most unnecessary of all. Now listen here. You are going to be moved out of here by the United States government. Oh. And here's the fine government scientist who's going to supervise your evacuation. Citizens, meet Dr. Rasmussen T. Finsdale.
Friends, we do intend to move you to a necessary place in our society. The first detonation will be on Wednesday, but the evacuation will proceed immediately. Thank you and good luck.
And so, dear constituents, as I bid you farewell, I beg you, don't let me down. Just remember, your government is spending $1 million on one bomb just to blow your homes off the face of the earth. So show your appreciation.
Hooray!
Settle on yarn.
Hooray!
Settle on yarn.
Great day!
Make sure your barn.
They settle on yarn. Go
back! And Mr. Kane.
One, two, three.
Brace out your ears and listen close. I want to add to this glorified occasion by making a history-creating romantic announcement. I claimed as my bride in marriage none other than the ever-popular Miss Daisy May.
How dare you! Emma, give me one more!
Wow, busted head, wide open!
Wait a minute!
Get off.
Ah, does the head busting for this family? Magoon, you crazy! You know you can't claim a gal down here unless she catches you on Sadie Hawkins Day!
You heard the man! Sadie Hawkins Day ain't till Friday, and they're dropping the bomb on Wednesday! So there can't be no more Sadie Hawkins Day!
Now, since there ain't no more Sadie Hawkins Day, we's goes back to the code of the hills.
Whereby, if a male desires marriage with a female of the opposite sex, he can claim his beloved if and he gets approval of her next of kin. Ain't that right, Mayor Dog Meat?
It's absolutely correct.
Therefore, I claimed as my bride in marriage the aforementioned ever-popular Daisy May.
Well, now, is there any other claimers? Since there ain't no other claimers,
I also claims the ever-popular lady in question.
You does what?
Oh, I claims Daisy May.
Now, we talk about for the purposes of marriage?
Whatever. He's a-claiming a fall, I'm a-claiming a fall.
You really mean it?
Oh, I sure means it.
Okay, now, since we has two claimers, the choice has to be decided by Daisy May's next of kin.
Been decided!
What?
Daisy May's already done been promised to me by Daisy's closest relative, my very good friend, the ever-sensible Romeo Scrag.
Romeo Scrag?
He's a no good varmint and all object!
Now, Daisy May, is it true that Romeo is your next kin?
Well, yes, but it's the side of the family that...
Once a scrag, always a scrag.
Okay, Romeo, is it true that you gave Daisy May to Earthquake Magoon?
That's correct.
How could you make such a miserable decision?
Because Earthquake Magoon is a fine man. A man who put love in his heart. And a man who just put $4 in my side pocket. Bless you, my children.
Quiet, quiet, quiet. Now the nuptials be announced later. But right now we got to get on with the plans for the evacuation of Dog Patch.
Mammy, do something.
Just a minute. I've got something to say. Is there a government man here?
Yes, what is it?
You want to bomb this place because you couldn't find anything about it necessary, right?
That's right, madam.
Well, suppose we did find something necessary. What then?
Well, we certainly wouldn't want to bomb a community that made a necessary contribution to society.
Okay, then let's go spread out and find something necessary.
That's fine. We got to save our Sadie Hawkins Day.
We got to protect the rights of womanhood.
But you heard, you fellow citizens. They wants to get up and get out of here.
Yeah, we wants to get up and get out of here.
And what about these fine young maidens? I mean, they got a right to get out of this miserable pest hole and see the outside world.
Mary, we want to see the rest of the world. Yeah. We want to get cityfied.
We want to spread out.
Culturize.
Modernize.
We want to broaden our horizons.
Oh.
You want to broaden your horizons, does you? Well, let me tell you something. Your horizons is broadening up already. Particularly yours. You got any idea what they got waiting for you out there? The horrible, miserable customs.
That's what.
Like me.
something necessary.
But Abner, don't you realize what you just done? You finally asked me to marry you.
Oh, yeah, I know. But come on, Daisy. We gotta find something necessary. Our whole town's just gonna be...
Why did you do it?
Oh, I don't know. I just done it, that's all.
But why?
Well, there you were, your sweet usual self. And there was old Earthquake, looking at you like a hound dog on the first day of hunting season. And I ain't gonna let no one look at you like a hound dog. Well, especially not a hound dog like Magoon. So I just does and done it, that's all.
Does this mean you aim to let me catch you, even we have Sadie Hawkins Day?
Well, reckon so.
Oh, Abner, what took you so long?
Well, I don't know, Daisy. Well, some years I was wanted too awful bad, but I couldn't. Well, I don't know why I couldn't, but I couldn't.
There must have been a reason.
Oh, yeah, but what was it? Well, take last year's race. Well, there I was, eloping along with my usual bust of brilliant speed, when I turned around and seen you, sweet and pretty, reaching out your hand to grab me for life. And all of a sudden, I hear this little voice inside of my head to holler, "Abner boy, take off!" And I took.
But that's all behind us now.
You really reckon?
And life's gonna be full of so many wonderful things. Things you've been deserving for such a long, long time.
Namely what? Namely me, someone who as yet ain't taken. Namely me, that is how I'll remain unless you get me, shall we say, in the family way. Come next Sadie Hawkins Day. You crave arms to make you tingle, namely mine, to a bachelor who's single. That sounds fine. Comes the day I'll no longer bachelor, naturally I'll be true. And who could I be truest to? Namely
Square and help.
Nice.
We gotta get on down
to
the town square and help save the town.
Come on, Daisy.
I'm sorry, but there is absolutely nothing necessary about a cigar box or the crankcase to a Model T Ford. Next.
Well, I'm next. How about an application blank to the Chaka Khan fan club?
Next.
Oh, five keep cool with cool ring buttons.
Next.
How about a round trip ticket to the birthplace of Elvis Presley?
Move along. Next. But there's no printing in it. The pages are all blank.
Well, we didn't have any money that year, so they sent it out blank just to keep up the goodwill.
Interesting, my good man, but hardly a necessity.
It might be if you lived in Dog Patch.
Look, this is an order. You pack your things because trucks will be leaving immediately.
Here comes Available Jones. He'll have something if anyone will.
I got it. Most necessary thing in Dog Patch. Right my ass out.
Quickly, man, what
now
is
you
it?
Just hold your horses here a second. Oh, get out of my way. Okay, gentlemen, put this on.
What?
Okay, put these on. All right, gentlemen, get ready for the stupefying Miss Stupefying Jones.
What does it do?
Oh, she's a deadly weapon. Guaranteed to stupefy any human male. Dead his tracks. I'll demonstrate. Hey, Speedy McRabbit! Come on over here! Get a load of this! Oh. Stupefy! Unstupefy!
But of what utility?
Well, you know, she'd be real invaluable to college football. She could stop Mississippi on the 1 yard line.
Oh, please. Who couldn't? Next. Yokumberry tonic?
I wants it up out of the berries of our yokumberry tree.
Madam, I have never heard of a yokumberry tree.
You wouldn't. There's only one of them in the whole country.
That's right, and it grows in their backyard.
Man, I ain't interested in your phony old yokumberry tonic.
Phony? Why, my boy, appetites it in just. Look at those muscles.
Yeah, look at those muscles.
I'm sorry, madam, but we already have all the tonics and then bodybuilders that we need.
Feels to me your body can still do with some building.
Look, that's enough. The evacuation will proceed immediately.
Maybe there's just nothing about us that's necessary.
I'm sorry. I'm afraid not. But I should think that you'd be delighted to get out of a place like this.
You don't rightly understand, mister. It may not look like much to you, but this here's our land, our soil. This is where we was raised.
Where our kinfolk is born and come.
Where our ancestors, who took their bare hands and made all of this out of the wilderness. Our beautiful skunk works.
The West Pork Chops Railroad.
That beautiful intersection of Hogfat Boulevard and Sheep Dip Drive.
Where we was planning to build our new hotel, the Leona Helmsley Hilton of Dog Patch.
Not to mention Conpong Square.
And Repulsive. And
Three Skulls. Why they calls us unnecessary.
Well, they just don't understand, Mammy. Oh, it's unnecessary. Just a speck on the map where the trail from the Smokies reaches Old Gopher Gap.
With a sheep in the meadow and the bees in the clump
something necessary, and he's got it. Now what?
Kickapoo joy juice. Eat big firewater.
She brought good and fit for human consumption.
Well, can it be produced inexpensively?
If you pay more than a nickel of wood, you're violating the fair trade laws.
Ooh. An alcoholic beverage that could be produced for a nickel a quart and then sold to the American public for 50 cents a quart. Perhaps I'd better taste it.
No need to bother, Doctor. Let me try it for you.
Well, if you'd like to, that would be fine. Has anyone ever taken this before?
No one in the whole world but my boy!
And this tonic is made from a tree that grows only in your backyard.
That's right. And it belongs to my boy out in the Yoakum.
Doctor! This is a matter for... Top! Angela! Security!
He's right. Yoakum. You'll have to come to Washington immediately.
Yes, sir, Your Honor.
Now hear this, all of you. It appears this Yoakum Berry tonic may have certain miracle-like properties which well may alter our plans for the evacuation of Dogpatch, but it will need exhaustive tests on human guinea pigs. And since you will be the most affected by the outcomes of these tests, I'm asking, are there any among you who would volunteer to come to Washington to...
You've got one right here. And if he's going to look anything like Abner, well, you've got yourself one guinea pig. If that stuff will make something like that out of something like this, you got it.
Find an army truck waiting just down the road.
Mr. Sergeant, does this mean that we are going to be necessary after all?
My dear young lady, if these tests fulfill their promise, Dogpatch will not only become necessary, it very well may become completely indispensable.
Was shaken to its roots today by a White House announcement that a Dogpatch lad named Abner Yoakum has discovered a miracle drug which may revolutionize mankind.
Vas groznia zebradni Abner Yoakum, persona vas dranka Dogpatch, as goi prismoshka miracle drug usa prasmolia voldrizlivat capitalist tissue of lies.
Ola is Chinchong Dogpatch, USA. Confula Sabgu Abner Yoakum, near international implications very interesting.
The government has clamped top secrecy on extensive medical tests of the Abner Yoakum drug. To establish its effectiveness, six patriotic citizens from Dogpatch have volunteered as human guinea pigs. Comprehensive tests on these men started today, but the results will not be known for some time. A late bulletin has just been handed to me. The President of the United States has just summoned Abner Yoakum to the White House for a statement of Yoakum's intentions regarding his disposition of this drug.
Hark thou, you idiot!
Didn't you tell Yoakum of my offer of $1 million for the rights to manufacture that drug?
I did, General Bulmus, but he says he's only interested in what's good for the USA.
What's good for General Bulmus is good for the USA, and by R.J. Reynolds, don't you forget it. Right, boys?
Right!
Three rousing rods, a few huzzas, and a hip 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 hooray! What's good for General Bull Moose is good for the USA!
Batman! I want the manufacturing rights to that drug, and by E.R. Squibb and Sons, I don't care how I get it! Now, is Yoakum coming here?
Yes, but I don't think it'll help. He spoke to the president this morning. He wants to give it to the government.
Well, didn't you tell him that I could make a better offer than the government? I have more money.
But my dear General...
Don't you, my dear General, me, you bumbling, incompetent hillbilly creep. Don't you realize what you've done? Why, if I own this tonic, I could make all the money in the world, and I need it.
Ever since I was a child, I had a dream. A simple child's dream. And all that simple child wanted was to get his hands on all the money in the world before the greatest broker of them all called him to the big stock market in the sky. And you, you imbecile, you shattered that simple child's dream!
Won't be sweet. Won't be a voice, honey. Here, this will calm you.
What is it?
It's your Norman Vincent peel pill.
I'm not taking any more of those peel pills. They make me think too positive.
Mr. Yoakum's here to see you, sir.
Great, send him in. Appassionado stove. I may need you. Well, don't just stand there. Show him in. Show him in. My boy, my dear boy. I'm General Bull Moose, son.
Oh, howdy, General.
I believe you know the senator. And this is Miss Appassionata von Climax. She's my confidential secretary.
Confidential secretary?
Yeah, you can read all about me in confidential.
Oh, howdy, ma'am.
How do you do, Mr. Yoakum?
Sure, pretty fur, ma'am. Did you shoot it?
I kind of trapped it.
Well, sure is pretty. Well, when does the season open on that stuff?
It never closes.
Yoakum, my boy, it's time you and I talked a little business. Now, I'm offering you $1 million in cash for the rights to your drug.
Oh, but I already told the president.
President? What president?
Why, the president of the United States.
Oh, that president. Forget that, my boy. I don't think you comprehend what this elixir of yours can do.
Why, it stopped them bombing my hometown, and that's all I cares about.
Idealistic nonsense. Yoakum, I have access to secret government documents, and so far the tests show that this drug of yours exceeds the most fantastic discoveries of science.
Is that good?
Good! Why, my boy, will get every nail perfect for this. It makes fat men thin. Thin men fat. Removes hair from where you don't want it, puts it where it counts the most. It broadens the shoulders, narrows the hips, builds up the corpuscles, lowers the blood pressure, wakes you up in the morning, puts you to sleep at night, softens the beard, toughens the skin, and what's more, it'll clean your teeth and leave your breath alone.
Well, it sure got good manners, don't it?
Just say the word. We're ready to go into production. We'll bottle it, name it after you, call it Yoka Cola.
Yoka Cola?
Son, we'll make billions. And for starters, here's my check for $1 million.
Well, thanks, General. But if you don't mind, as a 100% red-blooded American, well, I reckon I'd rather give it to the United States government. And if you'll excuse me, I reckon I'd rather catch my bus home while he's a-running Sadie Hawkins Day tomorrow. And I don't want to miss it. Bye, General. Bye, Miss Confidential.
Oh, God, you can't give up $1 billion. Believe me, my boy, it just isn't thrifty.
Oh, I know, General, but I've always been kind of sporty with money. Oh, bye, y'all.
How do you like that? Well, I'm not through. Not yet. There's $1 billion in that drug, and I'm not selling short. Not the Merrill Lynch, Pierce, Thinner, and Bean, I'm not. Bug Bound! What is Sadie Hawkins Day?
Oh, well, monstrous dog patch custom where the gals chase the men, marry whomsoever they catches.
Can an outsider enter?
Sure can.
Aha! Then we got it. We go to dog patch. A passionata enters the Sadie Hawkins Day race. She runs the race. She catches Abner Yoakum. She marries Abner Yoakum. And by community property, she owns half of everything he owns. Specifically, Yoakum Berry Tonic. And then, if some accident should befall the poor fool, you, his young widow, will own the entire drug.
But, Woolsey, supposing I don't catch Abner? I never run anymore.
You'll run this time or you'll be back at Howard Johnson's. Five pounds! Will you make sure she catches it?
General, I knows the man for the job.
Then pack your things, Appassionato. We're headed for the hill. And I tell you, by Tennessee Money and Tennessee Williams, we'll show those hillbillies what's what. Right, boys?
Right!
He makes the rules and he intends to keep it that away. What's good for General Bull Moose is good for the USA.
Share him with the whole town.
You is so right, child.
Tell him to wait for me after everybody's gone.
Right.
That is, if he wants.
Don't worry, he
of you, son, and wants to thank you for keeping our town from being bombed.
Well, it weren't hardly nothing.
Hey, how's those guinea pig husbands of ours doing up there in Washington?
Oh, they's doing just fine. Well, they's all turning into fine, good-looking, handsome young men.
Tell us about Washington, son. Is it run by a bunch of crooks?
Oh, no, sir, Pappy. And Washington's a right pretty town. Well, everything up there's made out of that big old white marble, and you can hardly spit without hitting the National Shrine. Right, Sam?
That's right, and I ought to know, because I let a char of tobacco go in a strong wind, and it ricocheted around the Washington Monument, flew past Abraham Lincoln, and came to rest on Jefferson's dome.
Thank God it didn't hit none of the Confederacy!
Thank God!
Well, Sam got a $5 fine. Well, they got a law up there that says you can't deface no national shrine.
Never mind about no national shrine, Sam. Tell us about the government. All them crooks!
Well, there ain't no crooks up there, Pappy. As far as I can tell, Washington's a great place. And I'll tell you one thing right now. Well, our countries are doing just fine. Right, Sam?
You were so right, boy.
Them city folks and we-uns are pretty much alike.
Though they ain't used to living in the sticks.
We don't like stone or cement.
But we is in agreement.
When we get down to talking politics. The country's in the very best of hands, the best of hands, the best of hands.
The Treasury says the national debt is climbing to the sky,
and government expenditures have never been so high.
It makes a fella get a gleam of pride within his eye to see how our economy expands. The country's in the very best of hands. The country's in the very best of hands.
a bill. Whereases and two-wits are crowded in each codicil.
Such legal terminology would give your heart a thrill. There's phrases there that no one understands. The country's in the very best of hands.
A supposed connects the nominee.
The nominee's connected to the treasury. When he ain't connected to the treasury, he sits around on his thigh bone. He sits around this place he got, this big congressional parking lot. But just sits around on there, you know what? Up there they calls him their thigh bones. Them bones gonna fly skin, gonna exercise, friends, child skin, gonna tax us up to our eyes again. When it gets a ball from their thigh bones, the country's in the very best of hands. The best of hands. The best of hands.
In GOPs and Democrats, each hates the other one.
Lays always criticize how the country should be run.
But neither tells the public what the other's gone and done. As long as no one knows where no one stands. The country's in the very best of hands. They sits around in this place they're at, where folks in Congress is always sad. Just sits around on their excess fat. What are they causing their thigh bones? They sits around and they start to snore. Jumps up and hollers, I had the floor. Then sits right down where they sat before. So dignified and so wise again, why the budget doubles in size again. When it gets a ball from their thigh bones, the country's in the very best of hands. The best of hands. The best of hands.
The money that they taxes us is known as revenue.
Well, they compounds the collateral, subtracts the residue.
Don't worry about that principal and interest that accrues. They're shipping all that stuff to foreign lands.
The country's in the very best of hands.
Abner, we's mighty happy that you could make it back for Sadie Hawkins Day, and I'm here to remind the rest of y'all that the race starts at 2 o'clock. So if you've got any readying up to do, you best get to doing it.
Well, I'm a bit...
Hope y'all catch somebody.
Gentlemen, come over here to Available
Jones.
I got what you need in terms of running shoes.
What size got there, Anna?
What size you need?
14 Q.
M. Well, these are pretty narrow, but they're available.
Okay.
Well, where's Daisy? Why didn't she come out to meet me?
Well, maybe she don't want no part of you, son.
Look again. Maybe she does.
Oh, hi, Daisy.
Hi, Abner.
Oh, I sure missed you, Daisy.
I sure missed you too, Abner.
Oh, I'm so glad I got back in time for the race this afternoon.
Are you sure you still want to go through with it?
Oh, sure, I'm sure.
Has she figured out how I'm going to catch you so we both know what we's doing?
Well, not exactly.
I have. Just close your eyes and see if you can visualize it. Now you take off with your usual burst of brilliant speed.
Naturally.
I hightails it right after you.
Well, I sees it.
You heads out for Repulsive Rock.
I gotcha.
I takes a shortcut over Hog Fat Boulevard.
Well, I likes it.
You sees me coming and ducks off through South Billy Lane.
Well, I'm a ducking.
Now I'm gaining on you and we're heading for the promised land.
Goose Grease Gulch.
Right.
I sees it now. As my feet start slipping in those goose feathers, you starts gaining.
I starts gaining.
You's only a couple of feet behind me.
Couple of feet.
You reaches out your hand.
I'm reaching.
Your fingers try to grab me.
I'm grabbing.
And then.
Yes.
Well, I'm sorry, Daisy.
What happened?
Well, I puts on a brilliant burst of speed and dashes out of sight.
hurt you?
Oh, I don't know, Daisy. Well, I sure intended to, but now I just don't know.
Abner Yoakum!
Oh, but I knows this much, Daisy. I'm gonna get in that race this afternoon and do my darndest to let you catch me. And no matter what happens, I want you to know one thing. That I wish you the best of luck. Because if anybody deserves me, you do.
Picture the warm friendliness of a rattlesnake. Picture 5'10" of innocent manhood. Picture a hat covering a face of sinister rapacity. Picture two eyes peering out with powers of malevolent intent.
Someone call me!
Hey, Flegal, sashay on down here and make the general.
You're actually paralyzed with your eyes?
It is known in paralyzing circles as Flegal's famous fabulous paralyzing. When?
Well, can you put this whammy on Abner Yoakum long enough so that Miss Von Climax here can catch him this afternoon?
Naturally. Get the picture. Sadie Hawkins' day begins. Guns go off. Bachelors running late. Yoakum goes dashing by. I took something down. Hope takes my eyeballs. Reels back. Triple whammy! We take the flea and open back in the back.
What happens?
He's cutting his petrified, and all his red corpuscles and white corpuscles suddenly stand stock still and stupidly stare at each other. Whereupon, who dashes up and claims the body, but disappointingly stacked young lady.
Is he dead?
With Yoakum?
You can't always tell.
Well, do you guarantee he'll fall out?
Certainly.
Flegal, you deliver Yoakum this afternoon. You got a job with me for life.
At your service.
I have confidence in that little fellow. He's the same color as money.
All right, you fear-crazed bachelors.
When I fires off this here gun, you will disperse. Backside over tea kettle in all directions. When I fires this here gun again, this bevy of love-starved, Valentine-believing beauties will commence to chasing you. Now, there is no rules, and anything goes. Bachelors, is y'all ready? Maidens, is y'all ready? Okay, Sadie Hawkins Day has officially begun. Son, get back behind that line. Sadie Hawkins Day has officially begun.
Yeah! Dateline, Washington, D.C. Here in our nation's capital, the secret government tests on Abner Yoakum's miracle drug continue behind a cloak of top echelon security. While little is known of the progress of these six guinea pig volunteers from Dogpatch, rumor has it that their reactions have exceeded fondest hopes of the jubilant government scientists working in this super secret laboratory.
My pleasure, Your Honor.
Oh, my best wishes on your wedding. General Bulmus and your fiancée are waiting in the car.
Thanks.
Gentlemen, it's remarkable. Our reactions completely, utterly, precisely alike. What delicious conformity. Think of it, gentlemen. Think of it. Whoever controls this Yoakumberry tonic may well control the world. Think of the unbounded horizons of science. Someday we may be able to make all mankind look, act, think, feel, hope, desire, dream, buy and sell, inhale and exhale, exactly like these gentlemen right here. Oh, happy day when miracles take place and scientists control the human race. When we assume authority of human chromosomes and assembly line women, conveyor belt men, settle down in push button homes.
Oh, happy day when all the cells conform and the exceptional becomes the norm. When from a test tube we produce gargantuan zoonoses and assembly line babies, conveyor belt storks only come to push button homes. So much of this, so much of that for the ears and eyes. So much of this, so much of that for the toes and thighs. Part of the posture of the lot, that's the basic plan. What have we got? I'll tell you what, we've got man-made man. Oh, happy day when we can choose their looks from formula and scientific books. Personalities from psychiatric tomes and assembly line women, conveyor belt men, who settle down in push button homes. Oh, happy day when all the world can see a healthy, hearty, hale humanity. When even tired businessmen have hair upon their domes, Slenderella tight mothers and muscle beach dads living in gymnasium homes. Oh, happy day when in collective reigns no individuality remains. We'll be a race of busy bees in happy honeycombs with automaton couples, mechanical guests getting gassed in self-service homes. Chick after chick, chick after chick, rolling off the line. Chick after chick, chick after chick, in the same design. Nobody thin, nobody fat, everybody stacked. We guarantee they're gonna be firm and fully packed. Oh, happy day when boys and girls on dates can tell electrically if they are mates. If he goes for her kilowatts and she enjoys his own, you can bet your magnetic combustible shirt they'll wind up in high voltage homes.
Hello, gentlemen, back to work.
Dr. Finsdale.
Yes.
Oh, Cedric Softwick, State Department.
State Department? What division?
Agonizing reappraisal.
Oh, I see. Please, state your business.
How soon will you complete your test on the effects of Yoakum Berry Tonic?
In a week or so.
Impossible. You have 48 hours, White House directive.
But why?
We've just learned that a certain power is about to release news of a scientific discovery of enormous magnitude. International prestige demands that we beat them to it.
Who is it? And what do they have?
I can't mention the country, but the indications are that it is a hydromatic convertible droshky.
A convertible droshky?
In the summer, it's a tractor. In the winter, a collective trailer. And it runs on a new secret fuel distilled from high-octane borscht.
And you couldn't tell me the country?
My lips are sealed. But you can see the urgency. The president insists that your test be completed by midnight tomorrow.
I see.
Oh, good day, gentlemen.
Good day. Gentlemen, we will have to upbeat our tempo. Dr. Smithborn, take the volunteers below for their mass spectrographic isotopic double diathermal diaphonoscopes, please.
Yes, sir. Gentlemen, to the rear, march.
Beg pardon, Dr. Finsdale, but just what is a mass spectrographic isotopic double diathermal diaphonoscope?
Smithborn, do you mean to tell me that you, a super secret scientist in the government's supersonic super secret laboratory, you don't know what a mass spectrographic isotopic double diathermal diaphonoscope is?
No, sir.
How did you get a government job?
I was terribly loyal.
What's your IQ?
I don't have one. I was just loyal.
Well, just go. Dr. Krogemeyer, call Dogpatch, please, and notify the wives that their husbands will be released tomorrow evening. If they wish to come to Washington to pick them up, they may do so at the government's expense.
Very good, sir. Oh, Dr. Finsdale.
Sir.
I hate to sound stupid, but just what is a mass spectrographic isotopic double diathermal diaphonoscope?
Well, how should I know? I was terribly loyal, too.
I misses him too.
It's a special awful today, Sam. I got this cold, shuddery feeling, and I just know little Abner's in real mortal danger.
What makes you so sure?
I always get this terrible feeling when he's in trouble. It's a clutching, grabbing feeling right in here. Know what I mean?
Of course I do, honey. Every time I get that feeling, it's either a mite of gas, the approach of a creditor, or I button the wrong button on my drawers.
Oh, I'm so miserable, Sam.
Well, if you feel little Abner's really in mortal trouble, why don't you go to Mammy and have her conjure up one of her visions, see if he's all right.
I did, and she's inside conjuring up a vision right now. But I don't know whether she can conjure all the way to Washington.
Oh, don't you worry about Mammy. She can conjure.
But I sure wish she'd hurry.
Hey, where you going?
He's going to Washington to pick up our newly beautified husband.
Government set for us.
Say, what you got there?
Oh, but we bought all these from Available Jones.
It's his happiness guaranteed on your second honeymoon do-it-yourself kit.
Ooh, well, let's see what's in there.
Well, we've got a black lace nightie. Some sweet-smelling perfume.
That's
and
good.
And an album of the background music to Rama of the Jungle.
Didi, will you see little Abner when you're up there?
Oh, sure, Daisy. We'll look him up.
Be sure to tell him that I hopes he'll be happy.
Oh, sure, Daisy. We'll tell him. Now, come on, y'all. We gotta get down to the stairs.
Bye, Mary. now everything's gonna be all right.
Oh, how can it be? Now that my man's gone, I'll just never get married.
What'd you say that for?
Well, who'd want me now? I've waited around so long, I'm plumb wasted away.
Well, that may be, honey, but what you got left over is more than most folks starts out with.
No, Sam. I looked in the mirror this morning and there's no doubt about it. My good years is gone.
I guess you's right. After all, you is pushing 18.
I'm past my prime.
What a shame.
And I'm losing time.
Guess the old clock's run down.
17 last spring.
Ah, what a wasted love.
Still without a ring.
Would you become my wife?
I'm past my prime.
Use an early antique.
Look at this physique.
Just hear those old bones cream.
Where there was a glow.
Ain't there a glow no more.
All through the day I fret.
Brings you more regrets.
And larger silhouettes.
You climb the heights.
Highs over the hill.
Of romantic
my
nights.
My hand has lost its skill.
Comes the cruel and dull.
I'm feeling pale and drawn.
Lover boy has gone.
Doggone.
Oh,
I ask you who's a lady.
Oh,
use my
thoughts
elated. Like a mummy underground. When
oh,
you is antiquated, boys ain't enchantiquated. They propose you in the round. Life's like a pie.
And the happiest thing.
When you're young and spry.
Heaven's within your reach.
But it's just a crime.
How can it be sublime when you're past your prime?
When you're past your prime.
Solemn promises to give yourself to me.
I solemn promises. to give myself to you.
Body and soul?
Body and soul.
One at a time or both together?
You take your pick.
Lady, you just bought yourself a passport to ecstasy. Come on, mama. Come on.
Not now. We ain't got time. You get those ornery scribes, because we're going to need some help. And tell them to bring their socializing clothes.
Our soup and fish.
That's right. We is headed for high society country. And when we get there, they ain't going to be anyone soupier or fishier than we is.
Okay. Okay. Wait, come back. Boom!
Won't postpone those tests.
I've tried for a day and a half, and it's no use. Yoakum gives them the rights at midnight tonight.
Midnight, is it? Well, by Simmons' mattress and all his springs, I'm not taking this lying down. If I can't get possession of Yoakumberry tonic, I'll at least get Yoakum to tell me the secret formula. And there's only one man for the job. Press my evil eye Flegel button. Till midnight to get a secret formula out of Yoakum. Now, do you have a whammy that'll make a man tell the truth?
Naturally! It is known as Flegel's famous non-prevaricating veracitizing truth whammy. Now, what do you want on this whammy? The truth? The whole truth? The half-truth? Or a little of each?
You mean to say you have a half-truth-telling whammy?
In Washington, it's one of my biggest items.
Then we proceed with Flegel's original plan.
Right. I give him my suicidal sports car whammy. He jumps into some handy Jaguar and derives himself off the nearest cliff.
Capital. Veracitize him at once.
Okay. So who gets him loaded?
Loaded?
My truth whammy only works when the victim's gassed, pickled under the influence of alcohol.
But... Bullsey, you know Abner doesn't drink.
Well, why not?
Well, because he says he's 100% red-blooded American. And no 100% red-blooded American drinks, smokes, tells naughty jokes, necks, pets, or smooches.
Then who gave this country a population of 260 billion?
Some other sex offenses.
No. There must be a way to get that boy to take a drink.
I know. What about the society party you're giving for us tonight?
Oh, now we've got him. No 100% red-blooded American would dare refuse to toast his prospective bride. Champagne, all right?
Champagne's poignant.
Then let's proceed as planned. Now remember, we all have a part to play in this. You too, appassionata.
But, Wolf, sweet, supposing I make a mistake and louse everything up, what then?
Then you'll be back pushing those 28 flavors before noon.
To use my feminine wiles.
Feminine wiles?
Daisy, what you doing here?
I just had to come, Abner.
Well, how'd you get in?
I sneaked in. Oh, Abner, I just had to see you once more.
Oh, gosh, Daisy. Well, you sure is a sight for sore eyes.
Am I, Abner?
Well, you sure is.
I come up here, Abner, because since I know you so well, I thought I might be able to give your intended some advice.
Advice?
About some things that makes you happy.
Oh, sure, sweetie, you Daisy.
Like your breakfast. How much cream and sugar you like on your cold poke chops.
Well, Miss Appassionata ain't the cold poke chop type.
And how to dig your special worms and bait your hook. But most of all, how to fix up your home so it'd be a nice, loving home like the one you and I might have had.
Would have been a right nice one, too.
Remember that piece of land you always liked?
A smack between Poison Oak Gulch and Contagious Lane.
Right behind the school.
Nice view of the Skunk Works.
Walking distance from Unnecessary Mountain.
Sure, a pretty spot.
Well, we'd have had a sweet little home, Abner. Not some big old cold house like this one. Just close your eyes and picture it.
A Caesar rocking chair. A lamp. A couch.
And love, Abner. Don't forget love. You can tell when you open the door. You can tell when there's love in a home. Every picture you see seems to say,
Daisy, I'll give my word.
But Abner...
Besides, old Miss Appassionata's a pining to marry me, and well, I ain't aiming to break no more hearts than I already has.
Then Abner Yoakum, run for your life. That's right. They's aiming to kill you. That General Bullmoose and your precious intended.
Ah, Daisy, how can you say such a thing?
But it's true. I heard it in this very room.
Ah, Daisy, I'm starting to get angry. Well, you's making this up count of you a poor gal who's still miserably in love with me.
But, Abner...
For which I don't blame you, because I can understand how it might happen.
Abner Yoakum, run for your life.
Ah, Daisy, I want you to go home and forget all about me.
No, Abner.
You heard me now. I have spoken.
Oh, Mammy... Pappy, did you hear?
I sure did. Come on, gal. Let's get Earthquake and the rest through that gate. We's gonna save that boy's life whether he wants it or not. Even if we all gotta bust into that ballroom tonight.
These indignities! Who would dare crash into one of my parties?
You sent for me, General.
What's all this nonsense about a commotion down at the front gate?
It's true, sir. There's a mob of horrible-looking hillbillies that say they've arrived for the party.
It's that rabble from Dogpatch. They weren't invited.
There's a little old lady with a pipe. Says she's Yoakum's mother. Says if you don't let them in, it'll look suspicious. Like you were trying to hide something.
What's that?
She said something about going straight to Geraldo.
Geraldo! I can't afford an incident tonight, not when I only have until midnight to get my hands on that formula. All right, let them in.
Let them in, sir?
Well, clean them up, make them presentable. Put them in the west wing.
Yes, sir.
No, wait. Put them in the east wing. The wind is coming from the west.
Yes, sir.
Go keep an eye on Yoakum. Make sure he doesn't know they're here. You, call the police. Tell them I want a squad of men dispersed discreetly throughout the grounds, but unintrusive, hear me? I don't want to embarrass my guests.
Yes, sir. General Bullmoose, you're not serious about letting those miserable hillbillies into your home?
Well, you have to expect that sort of thing these days, my boy. There's just no limit to what you have to go through to get your hands on a measly couple of billion dollars.
But, General, what if they should be seen? Think of your dignity.
Dignity? Ha! Dignity's a thing of the past! Astor, Vanderbilt, Roosevelt, they could afford dignity. They didn't have to put up with all this modern-day nonsense, all these newfangled progressive ideas. Social security, old age pensions, light beer. I tried to tell them, but they wouldn't listen. I said, you just put a radical like Ronald Reagan in the White House, and they call it progress. Progress is the root of all evil. Progress is the cause of it all. Our living standards now so good, I had to change my neighborhood. Where is Hampton Cove? Billionaires are getting old-fashioned. Labor is the newfangled craze. Lousy basic minimums are getting so high. The workers in the plant are living better than I. My lawyers all advise me that it's cheaper to die. Bring back the good old days. Progress is the root of all evil. Progress is the cause of it all. The world has now progressed so far. We don't know where the hell we are. Ask Hillary Clinton. Gone are all the lovely Strauss waltzes. Gangster rap's becoming the craze. The modern generation's taste is really complex. The very things we used to love, it quickly rejects. Whoever thought that outer space would overtake sex? Bring back the good old days.
boy, but I'm sure you understand.
Oh, can't blame you, General.
Well, they hadn't ought to behave this way.
All right, get moving.
Earthquake, do something.
Where have you been?
Why didn't you come get me?
Wait, everybody! Don't leave!
Who's that?
Listen, General Bullmoose, we're real sorry about this here disturbance that we caused, but we was under the impression you aimed to hurt our good friend Abner, whom we loved and adores.
Preposterous!
But we see that we're wrong, and so we're all gonna go and quiet.
Double crossing, making a
grab! I use a gentleman.
Thank you, Abner. But I sure would hate for us to part enemies and almost all be friends. So I'm asking you if we could join you in a toast, Brother Bullmoose, to little Abner and to the future Mrs. Yoko.
Well, you no good!
Well, I'm not one to hold a grudge. Waiter, champagne.
I see both you, twin right.
To the blushing bride, may the flower of her innocence burst into blossom and bring happiness to this fine young man.
There you is, a ricocheting troop where we find Mr. Bullmoose.
Repeat the question.
Wolfie, no! Is you or is you not a no good, finnagling, double crossing, thieving crook?
Yes, madam, I am.
No, Wolfie, he's not. Hey, Jim, what did you intend doing with that video phone?
Subject him to Evil Eye Flegel's truth whammy.
No, Wolfie, no! So he killed you!
The secret formula of Yoakum Berry Tonic.
Oh, stop! We're gone, you intended to!
Further use the nefarious E.E. Flegel.
The purpose being?
To put a suicidal whammy on the gullible Yoakum. Jump into my fastest sports car.
Bullsey, no! Stop!
Drive himself over the nearest cliff.
Bullsey! Making it appear like...
accidental death.
When, for real and true, it was...
cold-blooded, premeditated murder.
No! Bullsey, now you has a confessed murderer. Take him away!
What is this? Unhand me! Put me down! You made a mistake!
Attention everyone! All residents of Dogpatch are hereby ordered to return to their homes immediately and to resume their orderly evacuation!
Evacuation?!
Are you crazy, man? But the bomb has been called off!
There are buses outside ready to transport you and the rest back to Dogpatch.
But Mr. Alderman, what about our Yoakum Berry Tonic?
Yeah!
The test has been declared a failure.
Oh, failure!
Attention! Now, all you women whose husbands have been used as guinea pigs, a special bus will take you to the laboratory immediately. Oh, Mr. Yoakum, I'm afraid you'll have to come along with them.
What?
You will find out at the laboratory. Step lively, everyone. This way, Mr. Yoakum.
Daisy! I won you fair and square. You're coming with me.
Oh, please, Earthquake. Not till I find out what happens to Abner, please.
All right. But you remember, you're mine now, forever and forever.
Yes, Earthquake. I'm yours now.
Mr.
way, ladies. Whatsoever.
Been taking Yoakumberry tonic all my life.
Regretfully true, Mr. Yoakum.
Oh, that no good, miserable tree.
Dr. Bensfield, the bus is waiting. Do they all go?
Well, except for these men and Mr. Yoakum, we will need them for further study. This way, gentlemen, please.
This way out.
It ain't normal. Shutting all with them.
Well, Daisy, well, I guess this is goodbye for a while.
It's goodbye forever.
Forever? Why?
I promised Earthquake that if he'd come up here and help save your life, that him and me'd get married. And we's gonna.
Earthquake, well, could I have one little moment alone with Daisy before you leave?
Well,
Please, Earthquake.
No messing around.
No messing around.
All right.
Oh, I knows how you feels, Daisy. But you gotta go through with it. For we lives by the code of the hills, and a promise is a promise.
Maybe there's something we can do.
Oh, too late now. But don't you worry none. For Earthquake's bound to be a fine man. Well, once he's married up with you.
Ain't never gonna be like it could be with you.
Please, Daisy.
You deserve two arms to hold you, namely mine, there to comfort and enfold you, rain or shine. Say the word and I'll wait forever, no matter what you do.
Time, Daisy!
All right, Earthquake.
Come on, Sugar Booger. See you, Abner. Listen, honey, when we get home, I'm gonna want you to make me a big old pot of pinto beans. You're gonna be good, ain't it? I can't wait. God, I'm good boy.
Oh, shut the door!
Make light of something so serious.
Oh, but there you, son. There's a sure way.
Well, what is it?
A special potion developed by our beloved founder, Jubilation Tea Compound.
Oh, Pappy. Well, we've taken too many tonics and potions already.
Well, you haven't
already.
Taken Compound's powerful, perpetual, passionizing, and romanticizing potion.
Well, Pappy, can that potion romanticize me and put all these boys back the way they was?
All I can tell you, son, is that when I was your age, I had a mite of your trouble myself, so I took me a little sip of that there potion.
What happened?
Well, as I wiped my mouth, your sweet, ugly mammy just came walking by, and I can only tell you that sort of creature looked exactly like Lillian Russell, Marilyn Monroe, and Gene Novak all rolled into one.
Oh, well, what is we waiting for? Come
now,
on.
Wait a minute. There's an important and special condition that goes along with this potion. It only works if you really and truly wants it to work.
Oh, it does, Pappy. Oh, more than anything in the whole world.
Abner, my boy, how about you boys?
We does too.
Then get moving. That Whitney written for man or beast. And with Earthquake, that covers both ends.
Oh, come on, fellas, let's go.
I'd like to send a telegram to Mammy Yukon, Marion Sam, and Daisy Mae Sprague, Dog Patch, USA. Message? Just three words. Stall, stall, stall!
$8 wedding.
Well, I got to get an $8 boot, and there's no telling how long it's gonna take me to get there. I'm there! Dearly beloved! Dearly beloved! Ah, dearly beloved!
What do you think you're doing?
Getting married?
Are you out of your mind? The plane and the bomb are already on their way. And listen, Dog Patch must be completely evacuated in 20 minutes.
Oh, we're gonna be out of here long before there.
Well, you see that you are. Or the army will move you out by force.
You heard the man, Sam. Now get to the I dozens.
That's right, Sam. Proceed. Only, I do wish you'd wait, Earthquake, dear, till all my kinfolk get here. Kind of this wedding's gonna mean so much to them.
Of course, my dear.
Why, with the bombing and all, they's all gonna move in with such a nice new home.
Of course, my dear.
With their new rich relative.
Most assuredly, my pet. Rich relative? Who?
Why, you, of course.
Me?
You don't think a scrag will let another scrag go homeless, long as they're related to anyone as well-heeled as the world's daddiest wrestler?
You mean you want them three miserable scrags to come live with us?
Naturally. The others will be along directly.
Others?
I sent Speedy McCrabbit out to tell them all the good news. I knew you'd want it that way, Uffy dear.
Sam, for a good
why, it's Uncle Unsociable Scrag and all his unthinkable children. God. Say hello to your new rich cousin.
And look who just come out of the swamp. Unappetizing Scrag.
Get off my foot.
Oh, well, upon my soul, if it isn't the Scarsdale Scrag.
Well, Sam, ain't you got some marrying to do?
I sure has. Well, batten down your hatches and grab hold of each other while I let's fly with my $8 wet. Dearly beloved, we've gathered here today. To put an unfortunate, miserable critter away. Remember poor Adam, who got married and so began that miserable race of creatures known as the married man. Then think about Samson, who was Israel's strongest male.
The strongest.
Till little Delilah went and gave him a ponytail.
Ponytail!
Save your objections. I'll forever hold your peace.
He's telling you stay to attention.
You sign in a genuine ironclad permanently. Don't let me influence you in saying those fateful words. Just let me remind you, getting married is for the birds. You get up at the crack of dawn. Stops the hogs and you mows the lawn. Saws the wood and performs the chores. While it's rainy and wet outdoors. You come home to familiar scenes. And a plate of familiar beans. There is 22 screaming kids. Making both of you flip your ears. You were jumping out of your skin. And your mother-in-law moves in.
We're good.
There is no place to rest your head. Cause the other folks in your bed. You was got to escape the noise. So you has a drink with the boys. You proceed to the old brass rail. The policemen throw you in jail. You can't get a cent from your wife. They incarcerate you for life. Now if you still want this little girl as your lawful mate, by powers invested, I pronounce you man and
wife.
Did you say stop this wedding?
That's right. I might claim Daisy May for myself. Yeah. You'll laugh out of the corner side of your face when Pappy gets here with his corn poems passionizing and romanticizing potion.
There ain't no such potion.
Oh, yes, there is.
Wait a minute. Maybe there is, maybe there ain't. But I got something to say. Now, this little girl, she has loved this fine young man all of her life. And even if it means giving up my passport to ecstasy and all them fine family relations, well, that's a sacrifice I'm willing to make.
Besides, there ain't no such potion.
Oh, yes, there is. Oh, I got it. I got it.
Oh, thanks, Pappy.
Now remember, it only works if you really and truly want it to work.
Oh, I does, Pappy. Oh, I sure does. Daisy.
Anna.
Little Abner, does you take Daisy May for your wife?
I does.
And Daisy, is you agreed?
I reckon I always was.
And now with my blessings, I pronounce as you man and...
Wait! Oh! Pappy, give me that sugar.
I've only got one more word to say.
Not one word. Not one syllable.
Just one little word.
Out. You hear me? Out. On your way.
Well, Joe, you and Paul can't keep that statue. Let's get on out of here.
We ain't leaving without our statue of jubilation.
Oh, look. Something's under a statue.
Well, you and the man of reason, please get out of here.
Some sign here, Abraham Lincoln.
No, there's a plane with a very big... Abraham Lincoln?
Yeah! Just listen to this! Become his language strategy!
Deface no national shrine.
What?
You can't deface it, you can't move it, and you can't bomb it.
Well, he's right. Colonel, stop that plane and notify Washington. Citizens of Dog Patch, the evacuation is ended.
And now with my blessings, I pronounce you man and wait!
Why?
This joyful event cannot be consummated until we pay homage to the one man who made it all possible. Who romanticized this boy? And who put them back the way they was, my God? And who saved our beloved town from being bombed? None other than that beloved man sitting there upon that horse. Jubilation, keep on.